This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is Radian Measures of Angles, Part 3, and we're going to be converting between degree measure and radian measure. So in my video, Radian Measure, Part 2, we determined that 180 degrees equals pi, or you could say pi radians. And this is what we looked at. We took the definition of radian measure. We know that if we did a full revolution, in degrees, we call that 360 degrees. But if this is a circle with radius 1, we just say that circumference is the same thing as the radian measure, and the circumference of a unit circle is just 2 pi. So that gets us to this important thing you always want to remember, that 180 degrees is the same thing as pi radians. So first of all, does it seem reasonable that 180 degrees is the same thing as pi? So let's look at this picture. We know 180 degrees forms this straight line from here to here, and so this arc length, does it make sense that the length of that is pi, is the unit circle? And remember, if it's 2 pi all the way around, then from here to over here, yes, that would be half of that, 180 degrees. So what about 90 degrees? Now we're taking half of this, right? Half of the 180 degree angle, so we have this arc length here. So let's see. Does it make sense that you can get the answer for whatever 90 degrees by dividing each of these by 2? 180 degrees by 2 gives you 90 degrees, so pi over 2, what do you write? Well, you just write pi over 2. So 90 degrees is the same as pi over 2 radians. Now you don't have to write radians. You could just write the number pi over 2. All right, what about 45 degrees? Well, that's half of the 90 degrees over here, right? So I have 90 degrees. If I divide it by 2, that's like multiplying by 1 half, right, to get 45. And so I have to take half of pi over 2 also. So that should be pi over 4, etc. Now, what if I wanted to know what 60 degrees was? Okay, well, there's different ways of doing it. I could draw the picture again, but if I know what 180 degrees is, how could I get 60? Well, so in other words, if I know that 180 degrees is equal to pi, and I'm trying to get 60, right, I want to know what 60 degrees equals, what could I do to 180 to get to 60? I could divide by 3, so 60 degrees must be pi over 3. But the thing is, not everybody could think of, oh, how am I going to get from 180 degrees to 60, etc. So we're going to learn how to convert between degrees and radians, basically using this important equation here. 180 degrees is the same thing as pi. That means if I write pi over 180 degrees, pi is the same thing as 180 degrees, so that's just the number 1. I could also write 180 degrees over pi, because again, 180 degrees is the same thing as pi, so that is equal to 1. So what I have is that these are what I call conversion factors here. You could take anything and multiply by pi over 180 degrees or 180 degrees over pi to convert from radians to degrees or degrees to pi. So the question is, how do you know which one to use? All right, so let's try this problem. Convert 45 degrees to radians. So you've got 45 degrees. All right, so here's the thing. I want to either multiply by pi over 180 degrees, or I want to multiply by 180 degrees over pi. And what do I want to have happen? I want not to have degrees. So I need to multiply this by the 1, so the degrees will cancel. So this is my choice right here. So if I write this as 45 degrees over 1, if I multiply by pi over 180 degrees, then I see that my degrees cancels. If you're not used to multiplying to in conversions, see my videos on conversions. Now what happens when I do this? The degrees cancel. And so now I just need to simplify by, you know, canceling with a 45 and 180. Now, when 45 goes into 180 four times, right? So if I cancel this, that's the degrees cancel also, right? I'm going to get 1, and that is 4. So my answer here is going to be, notice there's no degrees anymore, pi over 4, which is what we got in the last page. Right here, notice that we also figured out that 45 degrees is pi over 4 by thinking of this picture here and doing 180 and half, then do 90 and 1/2. We also got 45 degrees was the same as pi over 4. So that is how we convert degrees to radians. If I want to take radians and change it to degrees, so now I want to take, let's say, pi over 6 radians to degrees. Right, so I start with pi over 6. Now, I want to get my answer in degrees, so I want to multiply by something so I get degrees in my answer. So the choice will have to be 180 degrees over pi as opposed to pi over 180 degrees. I think if you're going to degrees, you want to put the degrees in the numerator. If you want to get rid of the degrees, you want to put the degrees in the denominator. So what happens here, which is kind of nice, is the pi's cancel, and I've got 180 over 6 degrees, so I'm going to have 30 degrees. So pi over 6 is the same thing as 30 degrees, just like 45, and pi over 4 was equal to 45 degrees, etc. And we'll do some more problems converting back and forth on the next video.
This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.